Hey everyone, Travis here at IEM San Jose on day one with Meteos, fresh off of his astounding victory against Pain Gaming wildcard team. Meteos, realistically, how serious did you guys take these guys going into this event? Because I feel like most of the time people maybe wouldn't worry too much about teams from Brazil, but then like the Kaboom thing happened. What went into this event and planning for those guys?
Well, we definitely didn't underestimate them. We just sort of prepared like we would against any other team. We sort of messed up our picks and vans to end up with Corki mid because it's not something we'd ever practiced, but which is one of those things we were like talking about it. And I guess we didn't expect them to ban Zed or something like that. And we wanted some sort of AD mid. Talon didn't really work for us in the past. And so we're like, how about Corki since we already have him? And so it kind of worked out, but I wouldn't really call it disrespect or anything. Like that could have happened against any team. We didn't prepare less for them than normal. So, I mean, they have Korean players in their teams. They did really well in their region. There's no reason not to take them seriously.
After having Corki mid, do you think that that's like a viable thing that might happen in the future? Or is it just sort of like, it just kind of happened?
Yeah, it seems viable to me. Okay. Corki just seems really good in general. He does a million damage. Yeah. Like, pretty much everything you could ever want in a champion.
Well, this is the first chance that you have had to compete in like a major tournament on patch 420, the new patch with all the jungle changes, etc. What was the experience like? How do you feel about the jungle right now, and how did that play out in the game?
I think the jungle is okay right now. It's sort of in a weird spot where I guess it hasn't really been figured out yet, like what the best thing to do is. It seems really punishing if you fall behind in the new jungle, because if you spend a lot of time ganking, then your jungle camps will be low levels if you're not constantly clearing them, and you get it's sort of the opposite of last season. Last season, you would get more XP if you kill a camp higher than you. Yeah. But this season, it's the same XP no matter what, but you'll get less XP if the camp's lower than you. So if you're not farming, and then you decide to farm, you get like really low XP. And if your ganks aren't working, then you fall extremely behind. So I think it sort of favors a more farming style, where just so you don't fall behind, like, you know, just keeping your head above water is my take on it. And I guess the jungle items are getting rebalanced a bit next patch, because right now Rangers is the only decent one. I'm not really a fan of the whole smiting player concept. It seems pretty weak, because I'm not sure if this is actually a thing in the game, but on the tooltip for Rangers Trailblazer, it says you get extra XP from camps that you smite. So that's just more incentive to want to smite camps. Like you get extra buffs, you get extra XP, it helps you actually farm. So if you're using your smite on players for a tiny bit better gank, it just doesn't seem that worth to me to have to, you know, commit an entire item to this thing. So that's sort of my take on it so far. It's just you want to play someone who can farm well enough and get Rangers. The other thing is the early clear is really punishing on a lot of champions. So on some champions, like what I had to do the second game is Jarvan doesn't really have a good clear. So I would have either had to clear my jungle and get really low and then recall, or just do one buff and level 2 gank. And I kind of messed up the gank. I think we could have killed him, but it's just something that's like an option now.
Do you feel, I mean, you guys looked really dominant, but Pain might not be, like, the most serious opponent. Do you guys feel a little, like, because it's been a while since you guys have competed, no LCS going on or anything like that, do you feel a little rusty at all, or do you guys think that you're still up to speed and where you guys were before?
I don't think we're as good as we were going into Worlds or anything, because over vacation, you know, like, we're all trying to see our families and stuff like that, just maybe relax a little bit. But we've been getting there. Scrims are going all right. You know, like, there's the classic trying to get back into it, losing every game phase every team goes through. But it's going okay. I think we played decently against Pain. We still had a lot of mistakes that we probably shouldn't be making, like just a lot of deaths or not being in the right spot at the right time. So it's things to work on. And I sort of see this tournament as, like, a benchmark just to see how we do. I didn't really have any expectations coming into it for, like, winning or whatever, but it's always cool to play against international teams and just get some practice before LCS starts.
Sort of jumping back to the jungle discussion we had a second ago, Saint Vicious here on the analyst desk actually tweeted a couple of weeks back that he felt as though with the current state of jungle, and if it stays that way for next season, he felt as though junglers aren't able to have as much of an impact on the game. Since you were, you know, just in this match, did you feel that way, or do you feel that sense? Did you have that sense at all?
I don't know. It's hard to say for the most part. Something I did for a little bit was just try to critique all the changes of the game and think about how I wanted the game to be played. But I sort of realized a while back that it's not really worth me worrying about how I think the game should be and just sort of taking it as it is. And so instead of worrying about how my impact is now compared to before, I just sort of try to maximize the impact I can have now. and just figure out what I can do with what I have instead of, you know, wishing what I had. So it's just one of those things. I guess jungling is a little weaker now, but you're still the role that can impact every single lane at the same time. So I think jungling still have a fine impact.
So how do you plan on preparing for tomorrow, and what are your thoughts going forward?
Well, tomorrow we play Alliance, so we're going to prepare a lot for that. And I think it'll be a close series. Alliance seems really good, so it might be hard for us, but we'll do our best.
Anything that you want to say, any shout-outs to any of your fans who haven't seen you guys on stage for a little bit?
Well, thank you to all of our fans who have continued to support us, as always. And hopefully we'll do well against Alliance.
Very good. Thank you so much, Meteos, for the interview. For everyone else, you can check out the rest of our coverage of all things IEM San Jose at ongamers.com.